हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल नॉलेज हब। फ्रेंड्स, सब्सक्राइब टू अवर चैनल एंड क्लिक द बेल आइकन फॉर द लेटेस्ट अपडेट। आज हम कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स की क्लास करने वाले हैं, जो कि क्लास नंबर 7 है। ऑलरेडी हम 6 क्लासेस कर चुके हैं। इन 6 क्लासेस में हमने जो कंप्लीट किया है, वो यूनिट 1 कंप्लीट किया है और यूनिट 2 कंप्लीट कर दिया है कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स का। एंड नाउ वी हैव टू स्टार्ट विद यूनिट 3rd, विच इज़ योर 3D. This is the first class of unit 3rd, and before that we had done, as I told you, about unit 1 and unit 2. So first of all, it's a huge request from my side to all the viewers, please go through with the subscribe button and please like, share and subscribe our channel so that many maximum people can get the information at once, and even though we can also enjoy the video as well. In reference towards the 3D here, so first of all we'll discuss about the 3D geometric primitives, and in the short descriptions I will be telling you right now, and then we'll go ahead in this class in a detail as well. Where that the 3D geometric primitives and a 3D application, basic geometric shapes and forms are considered that to be primitive. Such shapes and forms include like spheres, cubes or boxes, and toroids, cylinders, pyramids as well. And I will discuss moreover related to the 3D object representation. So the following 3D object representation method, we have your polygon surfaces, which is the set of adjacent polygon representing the object exterior. The second is you are displaying the curves and surfaces, which is using the spline and Bezier's curve. The third is the sweep representation, which use reflections, translations and rotation to the construct new shapes. And the fourth is the hierarchical models, so that combine the smaller or simpler shapes to construct some complex objects and scenes. The fifth is the scene graph, which is a DAG, which is directed acyclic graph to represent the scene and complex object. The sixth is the construction solid geometry. The fourth is the arc trees. Eighth is the fractal geometric method as well. Now I'll talk about the 3D geometric transformation here, that is the translation, scale and rotation, where we will assume that a right-handed coordinate system where the points we have in the terms of P, which is x, z, y, 1, and that vector we have your x, y, z, 0 as well, of the power P as well. The translation we have, which is 100, that will deal with it here as well, and scale will take about the origin as well. In the same cases, that will go ahead, we'll talk about the rotation about the coordinate axis as well. So, and we'll discuss about the 3D viewing, which is one eye collapses the 3D world to 2D retinal image, and a later brain has to reconstruct the 3D. And in computer graphics, this process occurs by projection, and a projection has a two parts. We'll talk about viewing transformation, that is your camera position and directions. Second is your perspective orthographic transformation, which is to reduce 3D to 2D and 3D projections as well. In the perspective projections, that identify all points with the line through the eye point, after which slice line with a viewing plane take intersections point as projection. Talk about the 3D clipping as well. It is a clipping of planes and viewing for that frustum that in 3D, and it works after the perspective transformation as well. Now we'll go ahead with the detail that we have to discuss. What do you mean by geometric primitive? That is very important. So what do you mean by geometric primitive here? In a geometric primitive, that are the basic geometrical shapes that used to construct the computer graphic scenes and resulting the final image. Each primitive has an attribute like size, color, line, width, and commonly used 2D geometric primitives that include, first we have, and that is your points. In the terms of points, and a point is an exact positions or locations on the plane surfaces. It is important to understand that a point is not a thing but a place here. And now the second we have is your line. In a line is a straight curve, and when geometry is used to model the real world, lines are used to represent the straight object and with negligible width and height as well. The next we have is your line segment. In the terms of line segment, where a line segment is a part of a line that is bounded by two endpoints and contain every point on the line between its endpoint. Examples of the line segment include the sides of the triangles or squares. Now we'll talk about the another one, which is your planes. Fourth geometric primitive we have is your planes. In terms of planes, a plane is any flat two-dimensional surfaces. A plane is a two-dimensional analog of a point, where zero dimensions and a line, one-dimensional, and a space that is three-dimensional. We'll talk about the next, which we have is your circles. In the terms of circles, a circle is a simple shape of Euclidean geometry that consisting of those points in a plane which is equidistant from a distant from a given point that called the center. The common distance of the points of a circle from its center is called its radius, and a circle that divides the plane into two regions, an interior and an exterior as well. The other we have is your ellipse. In ellipse here, that ellipse are closed curves and are bounded are the bounded case of the conic section, and the curve that results from the intersections of the circular cone and a plane that does not pass through its apex, and the other two open and unbounded cases are parabolas and hyperbolas, ellipses, and that can also arises as images of a circle under a parallel projection and some cases of perspective projection as well. The another we have is your triangles. In the triangles here, a triangle is one of the basic shapes of geometry, and a polygon with a three corners or vertices and three sides or the edges, which are line segment, and a triangle with vertices ABC that is denoted by the triangle ABC as well. The other we have is your polygon. In polygon, that in a geometry, a polygon is a traditionally plane figure that is bounded by a closed path or circuit that composed of a finite sequence of straight line segment, that is by a closed polygon chain, and these segments are called its edges or sides, and the points where the two edges meet at the polygon vertices or the corners, and n-gon is a polygon with n sides here. The other we'll discuss about it, and which is your spline. In spline, in the terms of spline here, that in mathematics, a spline is a spatial function defined piecewise and by polynomials, and in interpolating problems, that is your spline interpretation, that is often preferred to polynomial interpolations because it yields similar results, and even when using a low degree polynomial, while avoiding the range phenomena for the higher degree. That note that in a 3D application, basic geometric shapes and forms are considered to be a primitive rather than the above list. So such shapes and forms includes here, and that is your the spheres. In the terms of the spheres, and a sphere is a perfectly round geometrical object in a three-dimensional space, such as the shape of the round ball. The other we have is your cubes. In the terms of cubes, in a geometry, a cube is a three-dimensional solid object that bounded by a six square faces and facets or sides, with the three meeting at each vertex as well. The other we have your boxes. in the box is that the box describes a variety of containers and receptacles for the permanent use as a storage or for temporary use, often for transporting contents as well. Now we'll talk about the another one, which is toroids. In the terms of the toroids here, that in mathematics, a toroid is that is your net shaped that is object, and such as an O-ring, and it's basically it's an annular that shape is generated by a revolving geometrical figure around an axis as well. The other we have is your cylinders. In cylinders, that a cylinder is one of the most basic curvilinear geometric shapes, and the surfaces formed by a point at a fixed distance from a given straight line and the axis of the cylinder. The solid enclosed by the surface and by two planes perpendicular to the axis is also called cylinder here. Now we'll talk about the another one, which is your pyramids. In pyramids here, that in geometry, a pyramid is a polyhedron formed by connecting a polygon base and a point that called the apex, and each base edge and apex forms a triangle. It is a conic solid with polynomial base, and these are considered to be primitive in 3D modeling because they are the building block for many other shapes and forms as well. Now we'll discuss about the more in detail, which is to describe 3D representations of object. In 3D representations of objects, that what we have to discuss here, that is the graphic scenes that can contain many different kinds of objects like trees, flowers, clouds, rocks, water, bricks, wood paneling, and rubber, paper, marble, steel, glass, plastic, and cloth, just to mention a few. So it is probably not too surprising that there is no one method that we can use to describe the objects that will include all characteristics of these different materials and to produce realistic display of scenes as well. We need to use the representation that accurately model object characteristics as well. The polygon and the quadratic surfaces that provide the precise description for a simple Euclidean object such as polyhedron and ellipsoid, spline surfaces, and construction technique are useful for designing aircraft wings, gears, and other engineering structures with a structure with curved surfaces. Procedural methods such as a fractal constructions and particle systems that allow us to give accurate representations for clouds, clumps of grass, and other natural objects. Physically based modeling method that using systems in of interacting the forces that can use to describe the non-rigid behavior of the piece of cloth or a globe, and that is octree encoding are used to represent the internal feature of objects such as those obtained from medical CT image and the ISO surface display volume rendering, and the other visualization technique that are applied to three-dimensional discrete data sets to obtain visual representations of the data as well. In the same case, the representation schemes that for the solid objects are often divided into two broad categories, although not all represented fall nearly into one of the other of these two categories. We'll be talking about the boundary representation. In the boundary representation or B representation, describe a three-dimensional object as a set of surfaces that separate the object interior from the environment, and typical examples of boundary representations are polygon facets and spline patches. The space partitioning representations are used to describe the interior properties by partitioning the spatial region containing an object that into a set of small non-overlapping contiguous solid that usually the cubes and a common space partitioning descriptions for the three-dimensional object is an octree representation here. Now we'll go ahead with the detailed about it, and that is the other question is what is 3D transformation, and write the matrix of each transformation and write a short note on 3D transformation. So we'll go ahead with 3D transformation. In the terms of the 3D transformation here, and first of all we have to know about the translation. This has been asked of 6 marks here, that is the in a 3-dimensional homogeneous coordinate representation a point of the translated position where P equals to X, Y, Z and P dash is equals to X dash, Y dash and Z dash with the matrix operation. So with the same reference towards it, we'll be getting it as in the form of X dash, Y dash, Z dash 1, and that is equals to 100 dx, 010 dy, 001 dz, and 000 and 1 that here, and that will be multiplied by x, y, z and 1. So here in that P dash equals to T dot P that we had written here, and in the same cases we'll get the equation like X dash equals to X plus T X and Y dash equals to Y plus T Y and Z dash is equals to Z plus T Z here. So after that, an object is translated in a 3-dimensional by transforming each of the defining points of the object, and we obtain the inverse of the translation matrix above the negating the translation distance dx, dy and dz. With the same references, the rotation we'll talk about after the translation, that the rotation is a 3 dimensions is a more complex than the rotation in the 2 dimension, and in 2 dimension our rotation is prescribed by an angle of rotation theta 0 and a center of rotation P, and the 3-dimensional requires the prescriptions of an angle of rotation and the axis of rotation, where the canonical rotations are defined when one of the positive x, y, z that coordinate axis is chosen as the axis of rotation as well. And in the same contrary, that the rotation of the z-axis along about the z-axis, so that will be of course x dash equals to x cos theta minus y sine theta, and y dash will be x sine theta plus y cos theta, and z dash will be equals to z here. In the same cases, the y dash is we have in the terms of y, so that will be the y cos theta minus z sine theta, then y sine theta minus z plus cos theta, and then x dash equals to x theta. So in the same references, we'll be finding out the 3 matrices here, which is R, that is R, Z, Theta. So here for that, we'll get cos theta minus sine theta 0, 0. Then will be sine theta, cos theta 0, 0. And then 0, 0, 1, 0. 0 0 0 and 1. This is for the R Z theta. The second we have here is for R X theta, which is your 1 0 0 0. Then we have 0 cos theta minus sine theta 0, 0 sine theta cos theta 0 and 0 0 0 1 here. And for the other matrix we'll find it out, which is for R Y theta, which is equals to cos theta 0 sine theta 0 0 0 0 1 0 0. Then we have minus sine theta 0 cos theta 0 and of course 0 0 0 1 here. This is for R Y theta here. for scaling, if I'm talking about that, the scaling here, that the matrix expressions for the scaling transformation of a position, that p equals to x comma y comma z, that relative to the coordinate origin, that can be written in the form of in the reference towards the scaling purposes. So there will be having an equation here. For scaling, it would be in the form of the equation, that is x dash y dash z dash and 1, which is equals to sx 0 0 0 then 0 s y 0 0 0 0 s z 0 and of course 0 0 0 1 here, which is x y z 1. So here for that we'll be having p dash equals to s dot p, as we had represented here, that is x dash equals to x dot sx, y dash equals to y dot sy, and z dash equals to z dot sz here. So here for the scaling with respect to the fixed point, so scaling with respect to the selected fixed point where that can be represented with the following transformation sequence, that is to translate the fixed point to origin, scale the object relative to the coordinate origin, and then translate the fixed point back to its original position as well, and that will be written in the form, and we form the inverse scaling matrix by replacing the scaling parameter sx, xy, z and with their reciprocals as well. Now we'll go ahead with the discussion about it, which is to discuss here, and that is to derive the rotation about the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, and prove that for any rotation matrix. This has been asked in many time examination paper of 6 marks. So the equation we have, r inverse 0 equals to r minus 0 equals to r of t 0. And for this, that consider any arbitrary point P, x, y, z in an xy plane, and let the point P be the rotated anticlockwise by 0 degree and about the z axis to get the new positions P dash, which is x dash, y dash and z dash as well. And let the point P that make an angle phi with a positive x axis, and the transform coordinate, which is P dash, is x dash, y dash and z dash, that can be represented, that can be expressed in the terms of the angle 0 and phi. And we are in the same case. In the same cases that we'll go ahead with x dash equals to r cos 0 plus phi equals to r cos theta cos phi minus r sine theta sine phi. The other is your, which we'll talk about it, which is your y dash equals to r sine theta plus phi equals to r sine theta cos phi plus r cos theta sine phi. So that has been represented here. In the same case, that the coordinate of the original point P in a polar form has to be represented in the form of polar form, which is x equals to r cos phi and y equals to r sine phi, and substituting the value of the x and y in this, and so that we'll find it out, x dash equals to r x cos theta minus y sine theta, and y dash equals to x sine theta plus y cos theta. So, and z dash is equals to z here. So as the rotation is to be performed about the z axis in the homogeneous matrix that form, and we have in the same cases we'll be finding out with the same references here, and in the same cases that the representation would be in the form of x dash, y dash, z dash, 1 equals to cos theta minus sine theta 0 0 sine theta cos theta 0 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 0 1 and with that multiply x y z 1 here and the same references and for that the transformation equation for the rotation above the about the other two coordinate axes that can be obtained with a cycle permutations of the coordinate parameters x y z and that is use the replacement here that x tends to y y tends to z and then z tends to x as well to get the equation that to be in x axis rotation. And for that, we will be finding out for the value which is r theta plus that is r theta. So r minus r theta and that is r plus theta. So that will go ahead here. Which is your 1 0 0 0 0. Cos theta, sin theta, 0, 0 minus sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. That will be add up, that is multiplied by 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, cos theta minus sin theta, 0, sin theta, cos theta 0 and 0 0 1 which is equals to 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 0 1 which is equals to 1 here. Now for that, since cos square theta my plus sine square theta that is equals to 1 and this proves that r minus theta and r theta are the inverse of each other and therefore the r inverse theta equals to r theta and rt of theta that is equals to here. Now we'll discuss about the another one which is to what do you understand by the mirror reflection and write the homogeneous equation for the mirror reflection here. So in the same case we'll talk about the mirror reflection. Let's go ahead. In the terms of mirror reflection, that mirror reflection in three-dimensional geometry is also very analogous to that of the two-dimensional mirror reflection and there are the following three cases like reflection with respect to xy plane, reflection with respect to yz plane and reflection with respect to xz plane and the point after the reflection that can be calculated from the following equations is px dash y dash z dash is equals to mp of x dash with reflection with respect to xy plane. So that we have here is x dash y dash z dash 1 equals to 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 minus 1 0 and 0 0 0 1 x y z 1. And similarly the reflection with respect to the xz plane if I'm talking about, so here in this that minus 1 will come here and that remain the same here, that minus 1 come here and 1 is come here, that is the x plus z plane here. Now with the same references and reflection with respect to yz plane, then minus 1 come will be here in the first position and then that remain the same. So this will be changing by one by one. Now we'll discuss about the one more thing, that is the other thing is your to find out the transformation A and which aligns a vector V with a vector K along with the positive Z axis here. So to find out the transformation as I told you about it and that is which aligns a vector V with the vector K along with the positive Z axis. So we'll talk about it here. Transformation. So here in this, that is V equals to A1 AR plus BJ and plus CK. So here we apply the following sequence of steps to get the required transformation as well. That in step 1, that rotate about the x axis by an angle theta, so that the vector v rotates into the upper half of the xy xz plane as vector v here, that is v1. And then step 2, that to rotate the vector v1 about the y axis by an angle which is your theta 2, so v1 rotate to the positive z axis as a vector v2. And step 1 is implemented. We can see that the required angle of the rotation theta 1, that can be found by looking at the projection v under a yz plan as well. So here with the reference towards r 0 or 1, and that is of I, and then r theta of 1, that is of comma I, and then r theta of 2, that is your the theta j as well, and then in the same reference towards it we'll find it out for the another one as well. So the matrices for these we have as follows: r theta 1 comma I, that is equals to 1 0 0 0 0 c upon under root b square minus plus c square. The other one is just minus b upon under root b square plus c square, and then further 0. The other is 0, and that is your b upon under root b square minus plus of c square, and then here it is, that is your c upon under root b square plus c square, and then 0. Then again we have 0 0 0 1. This is a matrix for r theta I 1 I comma j here, and for r minus theta here, that it will be the different here, minus theta 2 j, where that matrix we have. The first is your under root b square plus c square upon under root a square plus b square plus c square, 0. Then other one we have is your minus a upon under root a square plus b square plus c square, and this is 0. Then second one is your second row is 0 1 0 0. The third is your a upon under root a square plus b square plus c square. Second is your 0. The another is your b square plus c square under root upon under root a square plus b square plus c square, and this is 0 as well. The fourth one is your 0 0 0 1 here, and for that here I'll go ahead with this, and that we will be finding out that is v, and that is your v equals to, we'll find it out for that, v equals to under root a square plus b square plus c square, and the lambda is your under root b square plus c square, we'll add that, and so we'll be implementing these things in the form, and that is instead of these long terms, we'll write it on in a short way, and that should be represented in the following as way. So here that will be represented in the form of a matrix, that will be lambda upon mod of v minus ab upon lambda of v minus ac upon lambda v 0. This is your 0, c upon lambda minus v upon lambda, and 0, a upon mod of v, b upon mod of v, and of course c upon mod of v, and then 0 0 0 0 1. This is a matrix here. Now we'll go ahead with another one, that is the find the transformation for the mirror reflection with respect to the given plane. So here let the plane of the reflection that to be specified by a normal vector n, and that the reference point which is of p theta, that is your x theta, y theta, and z theta, and to deduce the reflection to a mirror, that is reflection with respect to the XY plane, that to translate the P theta to the orientation and then align the normal vector N with respect to weather vector K normal to the XY plane, and then perform the mirror reflection in a XY plane, then reverse the step 1 and step 2 here. So for that sake we will be having, and that is AN will find it out first, and then AN inverse will find it out, and then in reference towards it will find out TV, TV inverse and M as well. So let's go ahead. So the lambda N, sorry, AN we have equals to lambda by an M mod N minus N1 N2 upon lambda N minus N1 N2 upon lambda mod N and 0. Second row is your 0, N1 upon lambda, N3 upon lambda minus N2 upon lambda 0, N1 upon mod of N, N2 upon mod of N, N3 upon mod of N, 0. Then 0, 0, 0, 1. This has been represented here. Now after that, we have AN inverse, which is lambda upon mod N, and that is your 0, N1 upon mod N, 0. That is the another one is your minus N1 N2 upon lambda mod N, that is minus N2 upon lambda N2 upon mod N, and then of course 0 minus N1 N2 upon lambda mod N minus N2 upon lambda N3 upon N mod and 0. This is 1 0 0 0 that has been represented here. Now for that references we'll have TV, which is 1 0 0 minus x theta 0 1 0 minus y theta 0 0 1, which is minus z theta, and 0 0 0, that is 1. For that is TV inverse if I'm talking about. So on that basis we have 1 0 0 x theta 0 1 0 y theta 0 0 1 z theta and 0 0 0 1 here. Now for the M here, that will find it out 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 minus 1 0 and 0 0 0 1. Now in this the cases we'll go ahead for the another one, that to find my matrix for the mirror reflection with respect to the plane passing through the origin and having a normal vector whose direction is n, which is I plus j plus n equals to I plus j plus k, which has been asked of 6 marks as well. So in the same cases we will be having a mod n, that is your root 3 and lambda is root 2. So with reference towards it we'll put the value and we'll find it out as well. And on the same contrary, that the equation will be finding out, and for that equation we have as n equals to I plus j plus k. For that we have mod n equals to root 3, lambda equals to under root 2, and for that TV we have, which is your 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1, and for TV inverse we have, that is 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 1, sorry, 1 0 and then 0 0 0 1 here. Then for the another one we had put the value and we'll find it out for that, which is of A of N inverse and M, and then of course we'll find it out for the T inverse, M inverse and as well as for all, and that I will go ahead here. So for that we'll have your AN equals to, which is your root 2 by 3 root 3 minus 1 root 2 root 3 minus 1 root 2 root 3 and this is 0 1 upon root 2 minus 1 upon root 2. So here we'll have after that a 0, and that is under the same cases here we'll go ahead and with the same references we'll put the value and that to be find it out, and in the same case 0 0 0 and then we have your the next matrix we have here is it is your the next one is your 1 upon root 3 1 upon root 3 1 upon root 3 and then 0 and the fourth one fourth row we have 0 0 0 1 for the an inverse if I'm talking about is equals to that is your root 2 upon root 3 0 1 upon root 3 0 second is your minus 1 upon root 2 root 3 1 upon root 2 1 upon root 3 0 minus 1 upon root 2 root 3 minus 1 upon root 2 1 upon root 3 0 and that is 0 0 0 1. So in the same cases we'll find it out for the m as well. M equals to 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 then 0 0 minus 1 0 and 0 0 0 1 here. For the reflection matrix we will be having, which is m n comma 0 theta, that is equals to t inverse and a n inverse m a n and t v. So that is equals to under that we'll find it out matrix 1 upon 3 minus 2 upon 3 minus 2 upon 3 0 minus 2 upon 3 1 upon 3 minus 2 upon 3 0 minus 2 upon 3 minus 2 upon 3 1 upon 3 0 and 0 0 0 1. Now we'll go ahead with other one, and that what we have to discuss here. That is your what do you understand by local scaling and overall scaling here. So local and overall scaling. In the terms of local and overall scaling here, this concept of scaling where homogeneous factor W equals to 1 is known as the local scaling, and in the scaling matrix that the diagonal element Sx, Sy and Sz have a value greater than 1 and or lesser than 1, that with the homogeneous factor 1, that is the general form of the local scaling matrix. And local scaling matrix is as I represented you here as well, that is in the form of Sx 0 0 0 and 0 Sy 0 0 and 0 0 Sz 0 and then 0 0 0 1. And for that, in overall scaling, the homogeneous factor has a sum value that is greater than 1 or less than 1, along with Sx, Sy, Sz is equals to 1 and the rest of the matrix elements are 0. The scaling effect of the expansion and the contraction that are the reverse of the local scaling, that is if the value of W is less than 1 it will expand, and if W is greater than 1 then it will contract. An example of an overall scaling matrix to double the size of its original size is to be as follows: 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 0 0.5. This is your overall scaling. Now we'll talk about the another one, that is the another question in the terms of it, and which is your apply overall scaling by a factor of two matrix for cube given that we have and we will be applying for that. So let's go ahead to do so. The question is here. We have 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0. And here it is 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1. Then we have 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 0, and then we have your 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. All then we have we want. So this is given. We have to apply overall scaling by a factor of 2 matrices for the cube given here. So here that is the requirement transformation matrix. We have a T matrix. So we'll find it out for the T matrix here. This T equals to 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 and 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. And for that the object that T into object, we have to find it out. And for this will be given, we'll be finding out the value here, and that is in the terms of it. So here we'll have 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 0 2. So here of this we'll multiply by the matrix that has been given here. So that is your 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1. That is 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 0 and 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. So here it is. So other than that, we will be solving out is that I will find it out the another matrix, which is 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 have here is the matrix we have, which is 0, 0.5, 0.5, 0, 0, 0.5, 0.5, and 0. Then we have 0, 0, 0.5, 0.5, 0, 0, 0.5, and 0.5. The other is your 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 0, 0, 0, 0. And then we have 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is the matrix that we'll find it out here. So hence the size of the resulting cube reduces to the half of the original size, and that is we have done here. Now we'll discuss about the another one, which is what is tilting, and find the tilting matrix as well. So first we'll discuss about tilting. So in the tilting here, that the tilting is defined as a rotation about an x-axis followed by the rotation about the y-axis. The required transformation matrix is to be obtained by the concatenating the two matrices that we need used to the column representation model, which will be in the form of t equals to r theta y comma j abstract r theta x comma I here. And that is known as comes under the tilting point. And in the same references with the regard of it, that we'll go ahead with the further one, and with the tilting here that we'll be finding out. Which is your cos theta y 0 sine theta y 0 0 1 0 0 माइनस साइन थीटा वाई 0 कॉस थीटा वाई 0 0 0 0 1 दैट इज वी हैव 1 0 0 0 0 कॉस थीटा एक्स माइनस साइन थीटा एक्स 0 0 साइन थीटा एक्स कॉस थीटा एक्स 0 0 0 0 1 With this, after solving it out, we'll find out the matrix as well. And the matrix to be R is to be follows. T equals to, which is your cos theta y, sin theta x, cos sin theta y, cos theta x, sin theta y, 0. That is your 0 cos theta x minus sin theta x and 0. And this is your minus sin theta y sin theta x cos theta y cos theta x cos theta y 0. And then 0, 0, 0, 1. So here the another question that has been arrived here, and that what we have to discuss about it, which is the other question, and that is given the tetrahedron PQRS, and this is the given in the column representative, and that you have to rotate PQRS about the x-axis such that it erects with base PQR existing on this xz plane, following by the four times the magnification about the fixed point, which is a point is 1, 1, 2, and in the same references we'll have to find it out. Here then the equation we have here, the PQRS tetrahedron is zero to 1, 1, 0, 0 under root 5, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 and 1, 1, 1, 1. So for that we'll have to find it out, and here for this, that to rotate the tetrahedron keeping the base PQR in the XYZ plane about the x-axis such that it gets erected and require a rotation by 90 degree in a clockwise direction, that theta equals to minus 90, and so the rotation matrix is to be as given follows. We'll find it out for the r theta x, and then I will be finding out to apply the PQRS, and then I will find out the value as well. R theta x, which is 1 0 0 0 0 cos minus 90 minus sine 90 minus 90 0 0 sine minus 90 cos minus 90 0 0 0 0 1 will put the value. That is 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 minus 1 0 0 and 0 0 0 1. Now for that, applying the given matrix, we'll have P dash Q dash R dash S dash with reference towards it. So we'll put the value and we'll find it out. So here we have, which is the matrix we have, 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 and then 0 minus 1 0 0 and 0 0 0 1 multiplied by, so in the same references here that we have another matrix is 0 2 1 1 0 0 under root 5 1 0 0 0 1 and 1 1 1 1. It will give you the matrix, which is 0 2 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 under root 5 minus under root 5 minus 1 and 1 1 1 1. Here for the magnification about the point A, that is your 1 1 2, we first translate the object to the origin, that is -1 -1 and -2, and then apply scaling with a factor, which is Sx equals to Sy and Sz, that is equals to 4, and finally apply the inverse transverse, that is your t. The coordinate we have is your 1 1 2 as well. For that, the required transformation is to be as given by like t1 equals to, we'll say that t1 equals to t 1 1 2, and that abstract is 4 4 4, and that is t is your -1 -1 -2 here. And for that, we'll say that for the t1 we'll find it out, and then after that we'll be solving it out as well. In the same references for the t1 we'll find it out, that is the matrix we have as your, that is 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 sorry 0 0 1 2 and 0 0 0 1 with this, then multiply by 4 0 0 0 0 4 0 0 0 0 0 4 0 0 and 0 0 0 1, and that multiplied by 1 0 0 minus 1 0 1 0 minus 1 0 0 1 minus 2 and 0 0 0 and 1 here as well. We'll find out for the t1 as well that the other matrix for this, that is your t1 equals to 4 0 0 1 0 4 0 1 0 0 4 2 and 0 0 0 1. For that we have 1 0 0 minus 1 0 1 0 minus 1 0 0 1 minus 2 and 0 0 0 1, which will give 4 0 0 minus 3 0 4 0 minus 3 0 0 4 minus 6 and 0 0 0 1. And for now, apply the transformation matrix with the object matrix that is obtained here. So for that, PQRS, that is of T1 dot object, and that is T1 PQRS as well. In the same references, we'll solve it at matrix in the form of, which is to be as follows: 4 0 0 minus 3 0 4 0 minus 3 0 0 4 minus 6 and 0 0 0 1 0 2 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 minus 5 minus 1 and 1 1 1 1. That will give -5 5 sorry -3 5 1 1 -3 -3 -3 1 -6 -6 -4 under root 5 -6, that is -10, and then 1 1 1 1. Now we'll discuss about the another one, that what we have to discuss here, that is, what do you understand by the 3D viewing? In the 3D viewing, a 3D viewing is an in general referred to as projection, and that is basically there are the two types of projection, that is parallel and perspective. So they are further classified into the following various categories. Like, projection has been divided into two, which is the perspective and parallel. And perspective is your converging projection, and the parallel is your parallel projection. Perspective projection has been divided into three, which is the one point, which is one principal vanishing point, two principal vanishing point, and the 3 point, that is three principal vanishing point. And in that, parallel has also been divided into two, which is the orthographic and oblique in orthographic that the projection perpendicular to the view plane, and oblique projection that not projection not perpendicular to the view plane. Orthographic has also been divided into two, which is your multi view and axonometric. In a multi view, that the view plane parallel to principal plane, and in an axonometric here, that is the view plane not parallel to principal plane. And that has also been divided into three, which is isometric, diametric, and trimetric in an axonometric. And in the oblique projection, that has been divided into one, that is general, and that has been divided into two, which is a cavalier and cabinet. Now here we'll go ahead with another one, that what we have to discuss here, which is what do you understand by a parallel projection, and also describe orthographic and oblique projection. So first we'll understand about the parallel projection, then we'll discuss about the orthographic and oblique projection here. So let's go ahead here. First we'll discuss about parallel projection. In the terms of the parallel projection here, when once the world's coordinate description of the object in a scene are converted to viewing coordinate, we can project a three-dimensional object onto a two-dimensional view plane, and there are the two basic projection method, which is the parallel projection and perspective projection. In a parallel projection, that the parallel projection coordinate positions are transformed to the view plane along with the parallel lines, and parallel projection that preserves relative proportions of the object, and this is the method used in drafting to produce the scale drawing of three-dimensional object, accurate view of the various side of an object, and that are obtained with a parallel projection. But this does not give that is had been drawing and if the three-dimensional object an accurate view of the various side of an object that are obtained with a parallel projection, and but this does not give us any realistic representation of the appearance of a three-dimensional object as well. So mathematically, descriptions of the parallel projection that we'll discuss about it, and a parallel projection transformation is determined by prescribing a direction vector v and a view plane, and the view plane is specified by its view plane reference point and view plane of normal, that is the object point p is located x, y, z in a world coordinate, and the problem is to determine the image point coordinate as well. If the projection vector v has the directions of the view plane normal and the projection is said to be orthographic, then otherwise it is called oblique, and some common subcategories of orthographic projections are. So the first we have is your isometric. In isometric, that the directions of the projection that makes equal angle with all of the three principal axes. The second is your diametric. In diametric, the direction of the projection makes equal angle with exactly two of the principal axes. The third we have is your trimetric. In this, the direction of the projection makes unequal angle with the three principal axes, and some of the common subcategory of the oblique projections we have, and that is your cavalier and cabinet. In oblique projection, first is your cavalier. In this, that the directions of the projection is chosen so that there is no foreshortening of lines perpendicular to an XY plane. The second we have is your cabinet. In this, that the direction of the projection is chosen so that lines perpendicular to XY plane that are foreshortened by and half their lens, example like for orthographic projection onto a xy plane. where x dash equals to x and y dash equals to 1, z dash equals to 0. So the matrix we'll get here is that is 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 and 0 0 0 0 1. This is the matrix. We'll find it out. Now we'll discuss the another one, which is what do you understand by the perspective projection, and also define the anomalies of perspective projection. And the other question they can ask you in the terms of it, that only, that is to derive the perspective projection transformation matrix. So the perspective projections, here we will be discussing this in the next coming class, because it will be exceeded more than an hour. So we'll continue with this in the next coming class. So first of all, it's a huge request from my side to all the viewers. Please go through with the subscribe button and please like, share and subscribe our channel, so that many and maximum people can get the information at once, and even though you can also enjoy the video as well. In the same cases, and first of all, that what we had covered up in the computer graphics, that we'll gone through with that. And unit 1, we had covered up the graphics devices, which is the introductions and the line generations, types of computer graphics devices, graphic displays, random scan display, raster scan display, frame buffer and video controller, points and line drawing algorithm, circle generating algorithm, midpoint circle generating algorithm, and parallel versions of these algorithm here. The second unit is a transformation here. So the second unit is a transformation, where we had to cover up the transformation, basic transformation, metric representation and homogeneous coordinate, composite transformation, reflections and shearing, windowing and clipping, VUV pipeline, wing transformation, 2D clipping algorithm, line clipping algorithm such as Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm, Liang-Basky algorithm, line clipping against non-rectangular clip window, polygon clipping, Sutherland-Hodgman polygon clipping, Wheeler and Atherton polygon clipping, and a curve clipping and text clipping as well. In unit 3, we had covered up the three dimensional, 3D geometric primitives, 3D object representations, 3D transformation, 3D viewing, projection, 3D clipping as well. In unit 4, we had covered up the curves and the surfaces, which is, you will have to complete that as well. That is your curves and surfaces, quadratic surfaces, as well as spheres, ellipsoids, blobby objects, introductory concepts of spline, as well as B-spline, Bezier's curves and surfaces, hidden lines and surfaces, back face detection algorithm, depth buffer method, up buffer method, scan line method, basic illumination method, ambient light, diffuse reflection, spectacular specular reflections and Phong model, combined approach, Vaughan model, intensity attenuation, color concentration, transparency and shadow as well. Very short answer type question also, that what we have to discuss about it in this next coming classes. And first of all, it's a huge request from my side to all the viewers, please go through with the subscribe button and please like, share and subscribe our channel, so that many and maximum people can get the information at once, and even though you can also enjoy the video as well. We will be provided each and every video here, which we are doing via computer graphics, non-verbal reasoning, verbal reasoning, and as well as your data warehouse and data mining, and quantitative aptitude, and as well as managerial economics, and we will do moreover related to the other one, and that what we have to discuss as well. So we'll go ahead with the further one, and that is, even though we had doing the DBMS, that is the database management system as well. So thank you, hope you enjoy this video. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and give a suggestion on a comment box. Please like, share and subscribe our channel, so that many and maximum people can get the information at once, and even though you can also enjoy the video as well. Thank you, and thanks to all those subscribers who had subscribed our channel, because your support is very important to us. Thank you.